We've all met that person with that special little something, that man or woman that lights up a room.
That's right. And our next guest says that we all have the ability to be the it girl or guy. You sure do.
Oh,
and here to discuss her book, Discovering the It Factor Within You, is Leesa Rowland. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Leesa.
Well, you look like an it woman, that's for sure.
Thank you.
Yeah, love the fashion.
You. Right.
Thank you so much. So talk to us about the it factor. What is it is exactly? What is it?
Well, I wrote the book, The It Factor, to share my story and to give other people hope and inspiration that may be going through similar circumstances or challenges.
Yeah, so and if you had everybody, to define the it factor for us, what is it?
Everybody has the it factor. Mm-hmm. It's an amalgamation of your charisma, your inner drive, and your inner strength.
Really?
Okay, you say everyone
and
has
and your magnetism.
It. I like that, but everyone doesn't display that, so how can you bring that it factor out of you?
That's the key. Mm-hmm. That's the key. That's what the book's about. Yes, everybody has the it factor.
They do. Some people are born with it, though, right?
Everybody's born with it.
Okay.
You just have to discover it.
Okay, so what are some of the tips you give in the book to helping discover that it factor and bringing it to the surface?
I think that it's very important to get to know your inner self, your spiritual side, and your soul.
Okay.
It's having that inner strength that only comes through going within, through meditation, through yoga, through chanting, through going through different problems in life and mastering them and having that oomph and the charisma to manifest your way through your problems.
Okay.
What do you think some of the things are that stop us from manifesting that? Because a lot of people, they just put a kibosh on it and don't even know they're doing it.
Self-doubt. Self-doubt and fear are great problems that people have.
They can paralyze people, emotionally, if you have a lot of self-doubt.
Fear can be paralyzing, but you just have to know that tomorrow's another day and that you can persevere and that you have a purpose, that your life matters.
How do we go about getting past those challenges? Because I know in the book you talk about challenges that people have faced, death, depression, et cetera, et cetera. How do we get past those roadblocks that may keep us from discovering our inner it factor?
Well, you have to remove yourself from the situation first.
Okay.
And journaling helps. It's very, when you're going through something, you might think that there's not a light at the end of the tunnel, but there always is.
Really?
And it's keeping your faith really through those situations.
It's definitely important. Mm-hmm. Now, you spoke about fear earlier. Now, is it true that before you became an author, you were an actress in horror films?
Yes, and I still do that.
Really?
Absolutely.
Ooh. Give us your best scream.
Yeah.
Ah!
That was getting a little shake with it. That was nice.
But,
Okay, so why horror films, though?
You know, it wasn't that I set out to do horror films. I just did one, then I got another one, and I really enjoy them.
You like getting killed?
Fun.
Like, he's like, oh, I like dying.
You know, sometimes I think I'm getting a little, I don't want to get killed anymore. I want to be the one who kills.
Oh. You want to do the slashing, huh?
Right.
Really?
But it's really fun.
Really?
It's fun, and people don't take themselves too seriously on those sets. Mm.
And you don't have nightmares after you film something gory and scary like that?
Not at all.
You go home
because
and
I know it's
it
not
off.
Real. Yeah. Mm. But you might go home kind of sore, but but it's not real. It's different.
What's the craziest thing that's happened to you on set?
Oh, in Slaughter Daughter, a movie that came out last year, it took me 3 days to be killed on set.
Oh,
what?
So.
Over and
my daughter
over.
First tried to, she tried to strangle me, she tried to beat me. Finally, she stabbed me to death.
But
it took a few days, so.
Okay.
Sometimes it does, you know? You just can't give it time.
There's no easy way to die.
Slaughter Daughter. All right.
Okay.
Now, how did you make the transition from being slaughtered to writing?
Well, I began writing about 5 years ago, and it's difficult when you're just talking about yourself and you're trying to relate mm-hmm. your experiences. And I just wanted my book to be what you can learn from me right. and not really just my memoir and about me.
Gotcha.
Right.
Gotcha.
Well, you're also an animal activist as well besides
Absolutely.
Acting and writing. So tell us about your nonprofit.
Oh, I have a nonprofit in New York City called Animal Ashram, and we rescue dogs and cats from the ACC's kill list.
Oh, wow.
They have they make out a list every evening of cats and dogs that they'll be killing them next morning. A lot of people don't know about that, but we work really hard during that time, from the time we get that to the time that their death row is up in the morning, trying to find them homes and fosters.
Oh, that's great work. Somebody needs to do it. Thank you
thank
so much
you so
for that
much.
And for helping us discover the it factor within us.
It factor.
All right.
Absolutely.
And we can all pick up these books wherever books are sold now, right?
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And you're watching Rise Entertainment 360.